If you find that all these invariant checkers become tedious to write, you may consider a language where invariants, pre- and post-conditions, are all built in. This is the case in Bertram Meyer's Eiffel language. In Eiffel, invariants become part of the classes. The invariants also are named. So if an invariant is violated, the name of the invariant becomes part of the diagnostic message. Here we have root has no parent, and what this does is simply checks whether the root attribute is a valid pointer, that is, it's not a void pointer. This is unequal in Eiffel, and this is what in other languages is called a null pointer. Here we have the invariant root is black, and it simply checks the color attribute of the root node to be black. And of course, there's more to it. Once you have defined such an invariant, the invariant will be automatically checked. Actually, it will be checked precisely according to the rules we set up previously. Do you still remember them? So, when does Eiffel check its invariants? Is it whenever some class attribute is read, whenever some attribute is written, at the beginning of each public method in the class, or is it at the end of each public method? Check all that apply.